Social Services. Tonight we have a homecoming at United Township. We're here at beautiful Soul Bowl, where the 4-2 Panthers are going to take on the 2-4 Alleman Pioneers. This is Doug Howe, along with Gary Taylor. Gary, what can we expect tonight?
Well, Doug, looking at the way the season's progressed, UT is looking for a reason to rebound here and to gain some momentum heading into to the tail end of the Western Big Six season here. Hoping to garner a playoff berth. And I'll tell you, every time Alleman has come in over to the Panther Den, they have played a heck of a ball game, and they've been so close all season long to just breaking those big ones. And I'll tell you, this promises to be an exciting Western Big Six game.
Yeah, that's right, Gary. Alleman comes in at 2-4, but they've been close in a lot of games. And, you know, they're just, they seem to be one or two touchdowns away from just, you know, taking a win home, and they could very easily be 4-2. They are 2-4 right now.
Yeah, very, very easily could step up and play the Panthers real hard tonight. And traditionally they have. They have come right over to the Panther Den and have it back down and put up a heck of a fight. I'll tell you, it's a coin toss out here. Whichever team plays the hardest, controls the line of scrimmage and actually executes on the offensive end and makes some big stops on the defensive end is probably going to come out the winner in this ballgame.
All right, we're ready to give you the starting lineup.
Okay, we've got Ryan Jones at a starting defensive back. Then we followed by Casey Krager. And also defensive back position, Nick Armetta. Other one, Jerry Johnson. Adam McGinnis. Okay, we've got Jake Steele wearing number 74. We've got Paul Tatey, number 52 on the defensive side. And then we've got number 60, Nick Doyle. And then we've got Chris Jones, number 66. Number 83, Chris Knack on the defensive side. And followed up by number 88, Nate Branch. And the head coach is Dana Just. Looks like a pretty tough, formidable defense set there tonight for all of them, Doug.
For the Panthers. Number 2, Colin Goble. Number 3, Justin Shadaman. Brian LeJohn, number 34, safety. Dustin Smolinski, the linebacker and fullback for the Panthers, number 45. Brian Dennison, number 55, 6'1", 175-pound linebacker. Brandon Fomel. Adam Flores, number 60. Adam, the sophomore. Number 61, Jeff Freeman, coming back from that knee injury to go both ways today. Number 63, Johnny Johnson, a 6-foot junior. Number 72, Dustin Abney. And number 84, Brian Seal. Mike Tracy is the head coach of the Panthers, and we'll be right back for the start of first half action on Channel 38, AT&T Cable Services. Okay, well, we have a beautiful night of football here. In about 10 seconds, we're going to have both teams line up and kick off. Soul Bowl is looking great today on homecoming day for the United Township Panthers. What a great night for football, Gary.
Boy, it sure is, Doug. I tell you, we've had some great nights of football this year in Western Big Six. And as you can see, the fans are certainly turning out. It's a good sign for football in the Quad City area. The programs are getting more sophisticated every year. The head coaches are spending a lot of time working with the kids. And you can see the quality of football has definitely taken a step forward in the last 5 to 10 years here. And it just makes it all the more exciting.
across the other side. It looks like to be about two-thirds full. We could very easily have 5,000-6,000 people here today. All right. Well, ready to kick off for the Panthers. Number 41, Scott Durbin. Scott's 5'8", 200 pounds. Sometimes fullback, sometimes linebacker. And here's the kick.
Okay, Nick Armetta.
He's got a little seam there, brought down at the 30-yard line by a host of Panthers. So that ball went down to the 10 on a long kick to United Township, and you never know whether they're going to kick that ball long or put it on the ground, but 20-yard return for Armetta.
Yeah, Nick Armetta returned that ball and comes straight up the seam. I'll tell you, it's going to be exciting to see how UT matches up and counters some of the offensive plays here that Alleman poses to bring. UT looks to be in somewhat of a 4-3 type of defense here, which is a little different.
Boy, we got a whistle right off the bat. This reminds me of last week's game. Before the first snap, we had a whistle right off the bat with somebody lining up offside. Well, the quarterback for the Panthers is number 9, Ryan Jones. And for the Pioneers, number 9, Ryan Jones. And they really missed today. The other quarterback, Jake Nelson, who had elbow surgery in Alabama this week and is out for the rest of the year. But I guess his sport is baseball, so his best sport is baseball. So we wish him well and hope he comes back and is able to play ball for the Pioneers. All right, first, it's a handoff.
Yeah, it looks like we had Adam McGinnis on the carrier up front there. He's struggling for a few yards. Looks like it was kind of a stalemate at the line of scrimmage. We see UT matching up into a 4-3 in the middle section of the field, but they're sending some people to play man-to-man defense on the wideouts, Doug. That's an interesting coverage because it looks like from previous games, Alleman's got a little bit of ability to throw the ball.
Split out wide for the Pioneers now is number 83, Chris Knack. But they're going to take the ball right up the middle again for no gain. I think they lost about 2 yards on that last play. It's going to be, looks like about third down and 17 for the Pioneers. They tried the middle of that line two times in a row now, to no avail.
Well, I'll tell you, it looks like Dustin Abney was one of the last guys to get up out of that pile. He's made some big plays for the Panthers in the last couple of weeks here.
Okay, well, wide up the Pioneers right now is number 5. Don Bayham. And a little play action. Oh, and it might have been intercepted. What?
Oh, we have an interception by Brian LeJones stepping in front of the receiver. Pretty big play.
You know, Jones just kind of lofted that ball up there. It was just up in the air too long. And Brian LeJones made a good adjustment to go get the ball. Nice play for the Panthers.
Okay, now we'll see how we've got the ball at first down and about the 34-yard line. Definitely with Alleman in their backs in the goal here, it's going to be a big, serious play.
Let's hand off to Smolinski. Gains about 3 yards up the left side of the line. It's going to be second and a long seven. And for the Panthers, number 88. Scott Lambrick.
Okay, let's see how Alleman's countering. It looks like they're into a 5-2 defense, kind of their traditional defense here. Oh, a lot of penetration up front, Doug.
I'll tell you what.
On the Pioneers, great surge coming from their linebacker spots at time. Adam McGinnis just way in the backfield for the Pioneers.
Krager was also back there. I'll tell you what, this is a play that didn't work very well last week, and it looks like the Pioneers have watched the tape.
Looks like Aaron Schofield's come in as a wideout for UT. Looks like we've got a little matchup action going on up front.
Almost
in a 6-2 this time.
And it's intercepted.
Oh, wow, we have an interception.
By number 8 of the... Or that number 9, Ryan Jones. I'll tell you what, goes from throwing an interception to making an interception play on his own.
And he stepped right in front of the guy who made the interception for UT, Brian LeJones.
Well, nice catch that Good, but we've got a flag. Let's see what we've got here on the call.
services, and we'll be back in a moment. Welcome back to Soul Bowl, where the Panthers just scored, and number 41 for the Panthers. Scott Durbin is about ready to kick off, and it is a long end over end kick, fielded at the 12-yard line. Number 41, I believe, for Jerry Johnson.
Yeah, 31, Jerry Johnson on the return. Got pretty nice field position to start their offensive set. The
field that at 12 and ran into about the 33, so you have about a 21-yard run back for Pioneer. It's going to be first and 10. Number 9, Ryan Jones, quarterback. All the plays, and the nice split those wide receivers way out, spreading the field on the Panthers.
Well, they sure do. They're trying nice. Oh, we've got a false start somewhere in there.
Was number 66 for Alleman. Chris Jones, and, is trying to get a little head start.
Adam Flores, both kind of jumping the gun. Looks like it's against the Pioneers. Yeah, it's interesting, Doug. You watch the defense line up on both sides of the ball here tonight. We seem to be having some key player matchups, some single-man assignments, and UT's actually going to man-to-man defense on the wideouts against the Pioneers.
Pioneers wideouts are number 5, Don Bam, on the left side. I can't see who's on the right side. Pitch, it's deep in the backfield. It's number 60 in the backfield for the Panthers that kind of made the running back go wide. That's Adam Flores who got deep back there.
Brought down by Dustin Smolinski.
Krieger just didn't have a whole lot of chance on that one. All right, it looks like a loss of about 2 yards. It's going to be second down to 17. Second 17 for the Pioneers.
Go with UT counter to four, actually a 5-2 that time. They slid in. A lot of pressure on the quarterback. Oh, and he's brought down by Adam Flores, number 60. Tremendous pressure by Brian Seals from his spot there. And I'll tell you, quarterback for Alleman just didn't have anywhere to go that time. He seemed to be swarmed.
Jones looked like he was trying to just do a little two-step drop back and a quick hit. And evidently, the wideout for the Panthers wasn't open on the play. But I'll tell you what, if you're going to have those kind of wide line splits, then United Township's going to be shooting the gaps. If you're going to split that wide in the line, then passing plays are going to be a little more difficult.
Yeah, you see Alleman coming in some wide splits, trying to spread the defense out, and it looks like UT is countering by they're coming to the gaps and coming to the holes, trying to neutralize the point of attack.
That time, the running back was brought down by number 63, John Johnson.
Looked like we had Terry Ford carrying the ball for Alleman that time.
Well, I'll tell you what, Alleman's pretty hurt themselves twice in a row by starting off their plays with a 5-yard penalty and just really haven't been able to get it going so far in the game.
Just off to a rough start. Hopefully see him settle down here. They're getting ready to punt. We'll see what kind of field position
Jones is
they're able to reestablish.
If they nice punt off, fielded at the 39-yard line by Shatterman.
Justin is the lead block thrown by Josh Shatterman. A little brotherly action there on the field tonight.
All right, so it looks like fielded that ball about 39, so got about a 9-yard run back for the Panthers, and they're ready to come back on the offense now. Good fielding, good field position at the 48-yard line, their own 48-yard line.
Okay, here we go. UT come to the line of scrimmage. A little confusion on the Alleman side. They've slid to a little bit of a stunning defense.
Swinton got the ball that time, brought down.
Looks like Terry Ford come hard from his linebacker spot up the gap.
Ford did a nice job, and they were showing blitz, and they did blitz the run well. And for the Pioneers now, number 83, Brian Rangel, and number 84, Brian Seals.
Okay, we're just about ready to...
Marcus Hayes comes to the ball.
About at the 4-minute mark here. It's still 7-0. Favor UT. UT in possession.
Splint. The run. Okay, UT's matching up under
best line surge we've seen for the Pioneers today. They came off the ball in a hurry and blew the defensive front four for United Township back on their heels that time. If they can continue to fire out like that, this will be a different kind of ball game.
Alleman's back in with a tight end formation right out of the eye here. Okay, they go to Johnson again. Searching forward.
Got for the first down. First down for the Pioneers.
Is your host, Jim Moore.
Thank you very much.
Second first down.
We put a paint around here. That theme music we have is from...
What a great surge here. You can see Alleman trying to make a statement to UT. Hey, hey, we're coming after you guys. Front line's really surging ahead. They're snapping off the ball hard.
What is this color?
And up the middle they go. Oh, no, kept that time by Jones, who was met by a host of United Township Panthers. I think first on the scene was number 56 for United Township. And I don't see his name. Is that Promel?
Is that Promel?
Yeah. And then Brian Promel that time first on the scene for the Panthers.
You feel welcome, but there's a sanctuary experience that it actually...
Okay, we got kind of an imbalance left here with double tight end formation on the eye for Alleman.
Looking to pass. And he's looking for number 24. Is that Krieger? Oh, underthrown that time. And looked like Krieger did a nice job of coming back to the ball.
Good defensive play, Doug, by Justin Chatham, who played the inside position on the ball there. Both players really going after the ball hard.
That back to both of them. Number 21, Mike Wood, looked to be the receiver on that pass play.
Okay, we got a double wide out and a double tight in an eye formation for Alleman right now. UT in somewhat of a 4-3. Looks like they're coming to the blitz. Jones got time to throw. His receivers are covered.
Oh, nice.
Big play. Big play. Mike Wood comes down with the ball for Alleman. Just went up and got it, Doug. I tell you, Brian Jones put the ball on the numbers hard out into the field. One of the UT players comes by to try to bat it away. And I'll tell you what, his watch Mike Wood go up and get that football. Boy, you can tell he wanted that one all the way.
Jones did a nice job that time, throwing against his body, rolling out left. He had Flores chasing him down and delivered a nice pass. About the only place that could have been caught. And he's looking for running room right now, a little quarterback draw. Looks like Jones has a gain of about 4, maybe 5 yards on that play. And right now the Pioneers are starting to move the ball.
Pioneers are making that offensive surge right up front. UT's trying to counter with a gap, slant at different points, and also bringing their
Garner off tackle play on the left side. And met there by two, ready and willing United Township Panthers.
Okay, we got a double wide, double tight eye formation for Alleman.
Let's go to a call. We have phone calls here.
Second and first man yeah. again to Johnson.
Yesterday.
Why not tell you, Dennison's right there again.
like he's going to be close to the first down for United Township.
Inside reverse that time. Inside reverse. Good discipline by Nate Brandt. Holt and seemed to read that play. Even though they gave up the first down, I'll tell you, you got to give Brandt credit. He certainly prevented a big play right there for us.
Well, that's a new wrinkle in the UT offense that I haven't seen. Very good. Here we are again. Double tight end formation. United Township just about couldn't be any tighter. Pitch to Shadaman, who has nowhere to go. Struggling, but hit that time by,
Paul,
was that 71?
Paul Tatey, 27, Casey Krager. I tell you, it's two or three pioneers right there on the pitch. Oh, got a man down here for Alleman. A little tough to see who that is at this point. Tell you, Doug, this would be a sore loss. That looks like Jerry Johnson, a fullback for Alleman. They certainly don't want to lose him at this point in the game. He's had some big running plays for them at this point.
Well, we're going to take a break here. Channel 38 AT&T Cable Services. This is Western Big Six football. The United Township Panthers and all the Pioneers, and we'll be back in a minute.
Alleman's went back into a 5-2, and they put a cushion in their defensive backs. They're playing off the ball.
Pass, and he's looking for Westbrook down the line. Terry Westbrook speaking down the right sideline, and Cersei is looking for him. Look, he just threw it just out of his reach. But
like
2 yards less on that throw might end up right in his arm.
Right in his arm, and I tell you, Chris Knock running for everything he had there, trying to stay with Westbrook that time.
Well, I'll tell you what, if you're going to stay with Westbrook, you've got to be pretty quick. Skip got the speed for United Township. All right, Marcus Hayes over the ball. Receiver split left and right.
Okay, Alleman's back in their 5-2 again. They're cushioning out on the corners.
But there's Shadaman. Shadaman trying to get for that first down. He's made it at the first down. Shadaman that time for the run from about 20-yard gain for Shadaman that time on the pitch play.
Jason Crabb brought him down there on the outside. Boy, I tell you, when he accelerated around the corner, it almost looked like a game breaker there.
Boy, he's got some speed. Josh Shadaman, 5'4", 145 pounds, just like his brother. He's nothing but all courage out there. No fear. Panthers receivers left and right.
Places to go that time, Doug. Jake Steele's been playing real tough on that corner and certainly didn't get many places to go that time.
He used to call him Swinsky's number. That was number 41, Scott Durbin on the run. Swinsky's been getting quite a bit of rest here in this game today. And a capable replacement. Durbin does a nice job when he's in there.
Here we had D'Amico Blazer bring the play in that time. Brian LeJones wide left. Looks like he's got Ryan Jones assigned to him. Alleman in the 6-2, a little jumping at the line of scrimmage.
And we got a flag. Looks like a busted play that time. He was looking for receivers, number 84 for United Township. That's Brian Seal, and Brian was well covered as was number 34, Brian Jones. So we have an illegal motion for the Panthers. Somebody in the backfield is moving, or somebody at the end receiver, one of those two is moving. In for the Panthers, number 83, Ryan Rangel with the play. Panther cheerleaders, Panther cheerleaders, trying to inspire the fans to have the team go fight and win.
Wow,
nice job that time.
I'll tell you what, Chris Knox stepped right up and was very close to picking that ball off. He had read that play, stepped up hard on that quick. 30 seconds.
7 yards and a touchdown. Josh Shadman, one rush for 29 yards. That was a big rush for them, a big first down in this series. Cercioni is 3 for 6, 1 interception and a touchdown pass to Palacio. And here's the kick for the Pioneers, and back to receive is Shadman. He's at the 20-yard line and tripped up by number 21 of the Pioneers, Mike Wood. Steve Patterson for the first half statistics. Thank you very much. All right, for the Pioneers, for the Panthers, rather, they're at their own 22-yard line. First down, and Cercioni ducks under center.
Yeah, Alleman's in their 5-2 defense.
Splinski
first man
the run. About a 6-yard gain that time for Splinski, who had a big hole on the right-hand side of the line. That's opened up courtesy of number 61 for the Panthers. That's Jeff Freeman and Chris Pruitt, number 76.
Gregor, nope. Looks like we've got a Panther down, Doug. It might
That's
be
Pruitt.
76 Pruitt. He's face down out there.
I want to tell again, major bookstores.
Looks like he was on the left side of the line. Maybe it was number 79 on the 49 time. Jeff Ryan Schleter that helped open up that hole on the right side. Well, I'll tell you what, left 41 to go in the second or third quarter, rather, and we've got an injury already. All right, we're going to take a timeout here at Sol Bowl, where the Panthers are leading 19-0. We'll be back right in just a minute. Doug Howell and Gary Taylor from Channel 38 AT&T Cable Services bringing you Western Big Six football. We're back here at Sol Bowl, where number 76, Chris Pruitt, has been helped off the field, and we hope that he has a speedy recovery. Recovery. And now in a quarterback for United Township, number 2, Colin Goldman. And Colin started the year quarterbacking. It looks like he's getting a little quarterback time here in this game.
Off in the 5-2.
He's got the quarterback keeper trying to get to the outside, run down hard that time by number 36 for the Pioneers.
Adam McGinnis, well, I'll tell you, he has just been a hawk on the ball, making some big plays here for the Pioneers. Certainly a big workhorse for Coach Dana Just on the defensive side. True team leader for those guys.
Well, Ben Sacco, one of the two sophomores that get a lot of playing time for the Panthers, is in with the play, and he'll stay in and be at the tight end or double tight end formation for the Panthers. And with motion inside handoff again on the reverse. This is LeJones. Brian LeJones scampering for a first down to about the 48-yard line.
Wrestled down by Chris Knack for Alleman. Boy, what a big hole opened up. And Brian LeJones accelerated through, made a nice couple of cuts there and opened up to the outside before finally being brought down.
Well, that's the second time they've run that inside reverse. The second time it's run for a first down. This time about 18 yards for first down for Brian LeJones. Minko Palacio in the game now. He'll stay in as the right tight end. Minko came in earlier in the game and caught a big first down, for a big touchdown pass for the Panthers.
It looks like first man ahead. Looks like Smolinski back in the game carrying the ball. What's he gained? About
a 5 yard.
Yards,
about a 6 yarder, it looks like. It's going to be specked down at 4 for the Panthers. About a 6 yard gain by Smolinski.
Quick opener for UT on that. Alleman kind of find the secret to stopping that further in the game, and even went to a 6-2 type of defense, plug in the middle, and looks like UT is countering, coming back once again to that inside play as Alleman has been sliding into their 5-2 defense.
Alleman in motion, first man through again, and Smolinski busted through for a first down, and about another 6 yard gain. Running right up the back of number 61 for the Panthers, Jeff Freeman. And they're just running right up that guard spot right now and getting first down coverage. I'll tell you what, right now the time of possession has got to be huge in favor. third down and about two to go for the Panthers. Nice keeper that time by Global. It's going to be third one. So 7 yard gain. You know, let's talk about those front guys in line for the Panthers. Number 51, Marcus Hayes. Marcus is a 5'10", 215-pound center. Number 50 in there for the Panthers. That's Adam Carton, a 6'1", 215-pound guard.
Looks like we had a quarterback keeper that time by Colin Goble. Counter with an inside blitz from Alleman. It's going to be close on the mark here, Doug. It was third and about... we've got first down.
First down. I want to continue on those guys. 61 for the Panthers is Jeff Freeman, a 6'185-pound guard. Number 79 for the Panthers, that's Ben Schleter, 6'2", 250-pound tackle. And who's the other tackle on the other side, Gary?
On the other side, we've got Robert Petro, who's been playing there, number 66. Looks like they've also been running, looks like, nope, 66 is still in there.
Yeah, Petro's still in there, and they've got, they've been switching on that tight end with 84, Brian Sales, number 40, Ben Sacco, and number 90, D'Amico Bellagio. I'll tell you what, I wanted to make sure we mentioned that line because they've really done an outstanding job today at controlling the line of scrimmage. Well, right now it's second down and seven. For the Panthers, and Colin Goble's getting a lot of playing time at quarterback.
Yeah, he sure is. This is real valuable experience as you head into the final games of the season, hoping for a playoff berth, gain some experience with some of your players, key situations.
Goble looking for running room, picking his way through. Gain of about, looks like 3 or 4 yards. It's going to be third down and about one for the Panthers. I'll tell you what, they put about 9 guys on the line of scrimmage that time for Alleman. And had that run to the outside, was able to pick up 3 or 4 yards. D'Amico Blasio in with the play.
Alleman's looking for a way to stiffen up that defense. We've got a big third down play here. Alleman's back against the wall. They certainly don't want to give up another touchdown into the third quarter here already. Second man, Irvin, tripped up at the line of scrimmage.
Well, see if he had the first down. They're stopping the clock. And it's not going to measure. First down, Panthers. 5:28 to go in the third quarter. And United Township right now just controlling the ball, controlling the clock, controlling the line of scrimmage.
Give Alleman a lot of credit. They're playing with an awful lot of heart, and their defense has certainly been on the field an awfully long time here, particularly in the second quarter, and now here into the third quarter, the offensive set for UT.
Nice play that time by the Panthers. It's United Township trying to run a little pitch play with the Jones, the right side. I believe we had Jason Pratt on the tackle that time.
Defensive side, Doug, we've had Paul Tatey in a lot of plays, number 52. He's a 222, 6-foot-pound defensive lineman and offensive lineman. So we've got some guys going both ways. Some pretty good signs there for Allen.
Okay, the German through the line of scrimmage, about a 4 yard gain, brought back. Signed by 3 Pioneers, including number 9. Ryan Jones, rather.
Well, I tell you, all of them stiffening it up, and these are hard yards for UT right now. And you've got guys like number 66, Chris Jones, has been playing seemingly on both sides of the ball at different points. He's a 6'1", 230-pound senior. There's some big guys out there that are playing an awful lot of quality minutes for Coach Just. And you can just see it's a big offensive and defensive war right on the line. These big guys are going at it each and every play.
And I believe Mike Tracy's just going to stay, keep running the ball. The Jones this time looking for running room, but nice tackle by number 36, Adam McGinnis. I'll tell you what, Third down now, and about 7 yards to go. Once he gains
about 30 seconds left in the third quarter, and UT with a key third down possession play here, just inside the 35-yard line.
And mark at the 25-second mark, so really there'd be no reason for the Panthers to run this play. In fact, it looks like they're not going to. They'll wait this out, and the clock will run out. It'll be the start of the fourth quarter.
Well, Panthers quickly out of the huddle after an Aaron Schofield entry into the game with a play. Looks like they're going to try to get something off here.
Right. I don't think they knew when the mark was. Knocked down. Nice job that time by number 27.
Casey Krager, one of their captains, nearly picked the ball off. Boy, Doug, I tell you, if he picks that ball off, we're looking at an Alleman touchdown on a counterplay by the defense that time.
I was pretty surprised that we lined up. I don't think we knew when the mark was because in 25 seconds that clock was going to run out and then start the fourth quarter. Well, here at Soul Bowl, it's 19-0 on homecoming night at United Township. Colin Gary Taylor on Channel 38, AT&T Cable Services, and we'll be back in a minute. If they play, all right, we're back at Soul Bowl. When we started the fourth quarter, well, we were waiting for an official. No idea what he was doing down the other end of the field, but he's back in position now, and we will start the fourth quarter.
Looks like a little substitution confusion, and all the Pioneers look like they're going to give Ryan Jones a little bit of a break here on returning that ball.
High short kick. That's going to be all nice punt. That's going to be down at the 4-yard line, 4.5-yard line. I'll tell you what. Number one for United Township, Chadman, could have caught that ball at about the 2. An excellent punt that time by Scott Durbin, who hung it high in the air. And now it's put the Pioneers deep in their own territory at the 4.5-yard line.
Well, we've seen, Doug, in past games when UT has really ended up playing well, there's been some key special teams play, particularly on the punt team, forcing the opposing team deep into their territory with tremendous coverage.
Well, that was a great punt. Caught an offset line that time for the Panthers, and they run up the middle. They're lined up strong left, ran up the middle, and trying to get a little distance between them and their own goal line. And it's going to be second down and 9 for the Pioneers. Split left and right. The 83, Chris Knock, and number 5, Dan Bam. Off tackle, about a 4-yard gain.
Casey Krager off tackle that time, coming out of the backfield for the Pioneers. Looks like they're gaining a little bit of breathing room here, pushing it to a third down. Looks to be at about, 3 yards to go. Pioneers are looking desperately to get some breathing room and try to march down the field to put that ball in the end zone.
Well, they really need a first down here. They don't want to have to punt in this situation, giving the ball back to the Panthers in good field position. A nice run in. Looks like first down yardage that time.
Yeah, they're going right back to their captain again, Doug Casey Krager, who is saying, hey, I'll shoulder the load, guys. Put the ball in my hands, and we'll do it. They've certainly come right out of here firing on this offensive set this far. We're at about 10:30 to play in the fourth quarter. UT looks like they continue to go.
45 for the Panthers, Dustin Spilinski. Right now, for United Township here in Soleville. couple of knees.
And looks like we got about 21 seconds left. We'll probably just see one play made here at this point in time.
Well, it's going to be a happy homecoming for United Township as they're going to win this game 32-0. And they're looking for another lineman. That would be number 50.
Adam Carton just enters the game in a big hurry. Looked like they were short one guy on the offensive side there.
And there's the knee by Garland Goble. And 19 seconds to go, and this is going to be it. Gary Taylor and Doug Howe, it's been our pleasure to bring you Western Big Six football today. Family Ties production on AT&T Cable Services, Channel 38.
Well, Doug, we got a final 32-0. The game has ended. Teams are coming across. I tell you, look at a play of the game. It's kind of hard to pick one in a game like this. Boy, you certainly had some big play workhorses on both sides of the ball. Hats off to Alleman for hanging in there. They're fighting through some adversity and give their kids credit all the world here that they did roll over. They didn't die. And you can see Coach Justice trying to build for the future. And we certainly wish him well through the rest of the season.
Well, I think if you're going to look at a big play, you have to look at that touchdown with 2 minutes to go in the second quarter where the Panthers took the ball back after Alton had gone on a long drive. football fan, man.
Guys, you guys, it was a gallant effort.
It was gallant.
Look out for the pool! Is there a lifeguard around in case somebody drowns?